Resident Evil.
Oh my god, we're playing as Claire. I wasn't expecting to be able to switch back so soon. Or at all. I was expecting this just to be Chris's half of the game. Alright, so we're all the way on danger. Is there anything else in here we can do? I'm gonna stare at some fake palm trees for a second. Seems like the way to do things. Oh, there we go. That'll help. Oh man, we've got tons of bowgun arrows. Jeez. Oh, we can open the case. I don't even need the handgun bullets I put in there. Hey. Get a magnum. Oh man, the choices. Alright, so I'm assuming we're at, like, the basest of base health. So if I remember my herb mixing class, this should be a full health herb, correct? It looks... Wait, what does that look like? I was gonna say tobacco, but it's too fine grain. Oh! Well, I wonder. Well, no, you've not come across anything like that, have you? I mean, Leon did. Back in Raccoon City. But I don't think you've come across anything like that, Claire. Alright, let's open this, shall we? No, we've gotta... Let's open this, shall we? Okay. How did I open these again? Yes, there we go. What do we have here? Magnum rounds, okay. Well, I'm gonna take the Magnum in that case, just in case. And why not? Well, could take the submachine guns, because I'm not gonna, we gotta be near the end of the game now, right? I'm not just gonna hold on to those forever. Alright, so what do we have here? I love that there's just a mansion underneath the base. I like a full-blown mansion. This is fantastic. I see what you did there. Oh, that is fantastic. I was gonna say, this is like the hallway where the dogs burst through the window. Well, not dogs. But it's pretty good anyway. Alright, so... Yep, thought so. Alright, so... Might as well use the bow gun, actually. It's got slime coming out of it, too. Well, or... Ichor, how do you spell it? But it's got blood coming out of it, just going all over the place. Oh, that is... Bowgun's actually handy for once. Ugh. Wait, did that splatter because... I shot it, or was it already gonna be that way anyway? There we go. Still can't aim with bow gun. Okay, you are dead. You were still moving for a minute, so I wasn't sure. Alright. Cool. Hello? Card reader. Oh, I thought that was a door. Jeez. Okay, security lock's active then. I don't know. Guess we'll figure out. Okay. I was like, do I actually have to enter that area and put myself at mortal peril, or is it just gonna be like, no, it's locked? Can I not do anything with this guy down? No? Okay. So this is just a, sort of a holding area, or... Oh. Well, what have we what do we have here? Is this another one of, Alfred's special areas? For lack of a better term. So, security file. Okay. So the Ashford family's most important secret is kept at this lab. As a safety precaution, I have installed a self-destruct device in the control room and have placed the activation code inside the computer. Once inputted, all door locks will be released to provide easy access to escape routes. By using the elevator that directly connects to the hangar, one should be able to escape from the lab easily. Please remember that I have used the name of my beloved ancestor for the activation code. Glory to the Ashfords, Alexander Ashford. Oh, that makes things easy, because it wasn't anybody I've done a voice for, so I guess it could be Alex Ashford, could just be my voice. It works. Turn the handle. Oh! Well, what do you... Oh, there. Oh, hey there. So, question. Will I die if I go forward? Because I've got nowhere else to go. Yes! Yes, indeed I will. I have not come across any... I did not come across a typewriter before then. Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Oh, my God. Game. I hate points of no return, but thank you so much for that one little kindness. I love instant death traps, don't you? They're so fair. I mean, I knew it was there, but I'm terrible at this game. That's my excuse, I'm terrible at the game. Okay. Let's get everything all kitted out again, shall we? Take you. Take plenty of you. Yep, and now we should be good. Alrighty, we can leave that one for now. And I'm gonna see you guys once we get back to where we were. Alright, see you in a minute. Aha! So this does work. Nope, okay, never mind, it doesn't. Alright, so let's see if we can do this time. Actually, let's go in here first, because otherwise I'm afraid I'll be crushed to death. No, I'm afraid I'll be crushed to life. Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Blindly Play Resident Evil Code Veronica with MioXFu. Please ignore the bad jokes. You know they're coming. I don't know how to make a joke. That's the true joke. Anyway, last time, we got crushed by a giant stone weight up above us. It's about to fall down again. That was some fun stuff. Ready? It's about to happen again. Just keep watching. What'd I tell you? Alright, so hopefully this time, I can run by without dying. I decided to cut the last episode short, because I didn't want you guys to just be sitting there watching me, Wait, no. I decided to cut the last episode short, because it was already going for quite a while. So we've taken a crystal. with apparently a key card in it. I mean, I've seen paperweights with like just a crystal ball with something in the middle like it like this before, but this is a little bit ridiculous. I could obtain the card if I could crack it. Oh, god damn it. Do I have to... Well, when Claire got crushed underneath there, I'm sure that cracked it. Why can't we just, like, throw it on the ground a little bit? Do I really need to run under there? Use it halfway under and run back out or something. I don't feel like I have the time. Maybe I'm wrong. No, that's the emergency evacuation. Oh, hey, here we go. Maybe there's something up here for us. Maybe. Probably not. Well, that's a thing below us. Is that just a meteor? Is the T-virus from space? How to release the security in emergency, turn both... Wait a minute. This doesn't say the same thing at all. The anti-BOW linear launcher should only be used in a first class emergency situation. To use, turn both the left and right keys clockwise simultaneously, and then push the keys in to release the safety lock. The weapon will be ready for use after the energy charge is complete and the weapon's lock is released. Okay, so that's the security release. Okay, so the dragonfly, I get that. It just seems that there's a lot going on still that we haven't even come across, like the giant spider. Whatever that die is that has Alfred's initials on it, or Alexander's, or Alexia's, the one with the Bioshock symbol on it. See, that's why I don't have enough time for that. Barely have time to run by. There's not enough time to just stop in the middle. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, I can line it up so I can run straight across. There is not enough time to go into the menu, though. And there's not really anything upstairs that I can use either. Oh, I forgot to unlock this. Whatever. Yeah, Magnum rounds. Okay. Maybe I'm missing something. Seriously, why can't I just shoot it? Just throw it at the ground really hard. Maybe I can give it to the tentacle, and that'll throw it, again, really hard. box from the other side. Of course. Nope. Can't even get close to it. Nope. Okay. I'm gonna have to go back this way anyway, so I might as well take care of it now. Ugh. The splatters of gore look so... they look so out of place, because they only almost have a cartoony look to them while they're streaking down the wall. Oh, it's great. We haven't really seen this sort of, like, blood splatter ever anywhere else, so... maybe... can we use... this? No need to use this. I'll leave this for Chris. Okay, never mind. We can't use that. What? Where... the Luger. Where's that coming into play? Let's take the knife. let's just... No, okay. I want to save Steve, but I can't figure out any good way to do it. Oh. Well, found some of those. Not that it can really do me any good without the shotgun, but maybe Chris can use it with his paperweight. Hmm. Problem is, and this is the real reason why I don't want to risk it, is if I go run under that stone weight and I misjudge the area, I get crushed. I have to go back to the beginning of this area and do it all again. Even if I'm not misjudging. Can I just put it through here? Even if I'm not misjudging the area. What's she looking at? Even if I'm not misjudging the area, then... I don't know. I don't think I have enough time to stop in the middle of the run and put it down. Video game or not. Because I think that, I don't know. Let's see. I'm running. I stop. Eh, it kind of picks it up again. But it's not really what I like. Oh, God. Every time. I should just look at that guy. There's nothing else in there. No. Okay. I'm like just hoping against hope there's something I'm missing. There's not enough room to really miss something in here. Ugh. Oh! Okay, so I can run under it twice, actually. Oh, that's what I'm afraid of. Okay. That makes things easier. Okay. Don't fuck me over, Capcom. I'm gonna just run straight. If I don't make it into that room, I'm gonna kill you. Yeah, fucked me over, Capcom. I hate you. Well, Claire's in a bit of a jam now. Oh. Can I put the bow gun on the the lever or something. She gets so much time to just walk out of there. Like,
oh, well, I put down the little paperweight. I guess I might want to get out of here now.
Alright, screw that. I'm not even gonna waste any time on that. Not right now. See, I know what I'm doing, kind of, not really. Whoops. It's okay, it's like 17 shots. Okay. Let's try this again, shall we? I've got so much pistol ammo, I don't even care. Bloody bloody blah, Veronica's the code. Aha, I get it, code Veronica. Ha 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 ha. That's so clever. Alfred, you tricky dick. I just don't like doing it. There's just not enough time. Okay, one more time, we're gonna celebrate. Oh god. Okay, we're in the right position. Take your time, Claire. No rush. Alright, so maybe this time we can go around to this side and try and fish it out. No? How the hell do we get that? I have anything. Maybe to hold it up? Or maybe I was hoping maybe I could put it back right side up and that would deactivate it. Do I have to run under quick and just do it all over again? I don't want to try that. That's the problem. I don't want to risk getting caught under there. Oh my god, what did I just do? That was ridiculous. Did that stop it? So does it just go down once for every time you go on it? I guess that... Okay. But also, oh my god, what a glitch that was. That was kind of crazy. Sorry, I had to redo that like three times. So, maybe, okay, two times I had to redo it. I had to do it three times and it was not fun. Anyway, should we... I'm gonna check this first. The emergency destruction system. What does it say on the back? I want to be able to read you. Oh, it just says emergency. Oh, no. Yes. Oh, we're holding on to the security card, you see? That's different. Yes. You can tell, can't you, Claire? This door's gonna shut behind you, isn't it? Oh, no, it's not, okay. This is a fancy room. Suits of armor. Is this some sort of weird fancy sewer? You can't go up the sides. That's what's getting me. Oh. Hello.
Steve?
You doing okay? Hanging in there?
Claire.
Did Mr. Spindly come back? Mr. Millions of Arms?
I can't do it! Who did this to you?
That crazy woman told me she was gonna perform the same experiment on me that she did on her own father. She's completely insane.
Oh.
What's wrong?
Claire! Can't breathe! Claire! Help me! Claire!
That was unexpected. And really freaking cool. One moment, my jaw's hanging in disbelief that they would kill me in just two hits. One second.
Oh my god!
I did not even have the time to turn around and run. Okay. Well, this is certainly going to be a fight. Okay, so Steve changes. I guess he hits puberty. No, that's a terrible joke to make at his expense. I guess he turns into a man. There we go. Yes, I'm going to take a few things with me this time. Like, everything that I can carry. Yes. This seems like the proper loadout I will need. Oh, I should have seen a boss coming. Oh, I should have seen it. Okay. I wasn't expecting Steve, though. Oh man, Steve. Guess your old father ain't that bad after all, is he? There we go. Okay, so now that I know that it's not gonna fall on me, unless I step on it again after it's reset, things are gonna be a little easier. Because now I can just wait. And just go under now. That's so much easier now. Jeez, I'm an idiot. Just done that from the get-go. I really wish that I could save. But no. That's not in the cards. Well, on the bright side, I didn't bring the grenade launcher with Chris. Steve can kill me in 2 hits. I can't believe that. Okay. So how am I supposed to get away from him? Okay. Wheels are turning in my head. So shooting him with the grenade launcher stunlocks him. He cannot swing his sword if I shoot him with a grenade launcher. However, it does not look like the grenade launcher is actually going to kill him. It looks like we're gonna have to fight Steve another time. Maybe, I don't know. Perhaps we're just supposed to trap Steve in there for now. Maybe. I don't know. Oh, actually, I need those. What I do know is that it does not look like I can run from him. At least not in the way I would run from a normal enemy. Maybe running itself is a bad idea. Perhaps. And this is a big perhaps. Perhaps I need to just back away slowly, firing on him every few moments. Perhaps as well, it is not just the grenade launcher that can hurt him. Actually, go back. I'm gonna pick up those submachine guns. If Steve is to go out, he's gonna go out the way he would have liked. In a blaze of action. Alright. Plus, I think I can actually... No, okay, I cannot move back with these, but they will be doing enough damage that it should stun him. Should. So that I can start moving backwards. This is a better plan than I could have come up with otherwise. Two hits. Wow, this puzzle is ridiculously easy now that I know what I'm doing. Oh, please don't be too far. Okay, we're good. It has to be just in the center. It can't just, like... Let's try this one more time, shall we? No, that does not stun him. Okay. Okay.